Your father kills your mother to be with his pregnant girlfriend he's known about 2 months. How does a child ever get over that?
That is tonight's top story. We're talking about the Roseboro murder, in which a Lancaster County funeral director is serving life in prison for killing his wife in their backyard pool 4 years ago.
Well, the four Roseboro children lost their mother while they were sleeping and have a father who will never come home. They invited me to that home to share how they're trying to turn so much sadness into something good. 13-year-old Noah goes under.
What was that?
A few feet away, 10-year-old Stella tries to lob one over. Then it's everybody out for a slice. Looks like the American dream, but it's not.
They block out the negative and they accentuate the positive. And I think that's how they're surviving. You know, you just hope and pray that they grow to be healthy adults.
The good part is that my dad's still here. The bad part is my mom's not.
Simple logic from a little girl who was six when daddy killed mommy in the same pool they are playing in.
They love their father. It is their father.
They see him every couple of months at the state prison in Frackville and say they prefer to remember him before.
He was a good businessman.
Their Aunt Susie, Jan Roseboro's only sister, is raising them.
Do you want to give him a 3-second start?
And while she runs relay races, serves the cold drinks, and does everything else a mother would do, she is also establishing a foundation in her sister's name.
People say, will you be able to do that? Because it just brings it up again and again.
But Susie says Jan Roseboro was all about children and will continue to be.
And we knew we wanted to do something for children of domestic violence and parental loss.
And hopefully provide some healing along the way.
I want them to be involved in this and see what positive they can make out of their lives on a heinous, you know, tragedy, that they can do something.
Susie also looked for healing when she visited Michael Roseboro in prison.
I saw him, maybe 2 years ago, but I haven't seen him since.
She says Roseboro not only did not apologize for killing her sister, but still denies it.
Do I forgive him? I pray for his soul. Absolutely. I pray for his soul for their sake.
The first meeting for the Jan Roseboro Foundation will be Sunday, August 12th at Stout's Black Angus in Adamstown, Lancaster County. It is a women's giving circle called Jan's Circle of Friends with a membership fee. The foundation's website is not up yet, but there is an email address, and you can get all that information at WGAL.com.